What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating an OSD cloud template. So let's get right into it. All right, so part two of our mini series, and it's all about creating an OSD cloud template. So again, like I said in part one, OSD cloud is all about using PowerShell, and I love using PowerShell. So first thing that we need to do is open up your PowerShell ISE as a full administrator. So I already did that, and I've been doing everything within my MDT server for this entire mini series, okay? So the first command for us to create our OSD cloud template, this is super simple, new OSD cloud template. Just run it, and you're going to see it output all kinds of crazy things at the command prompt. And once it's completed, you're done. It creates your first template. Now, I did notice a warning within the output, and that was about Dart. This is the warning that I received, could not find basically Dart 10, which is a cab file that I need for it to work properly. Now, if you saw part one, you saw when I installed Dart 10, it did not like the Windows PE or the Windows ADK that I had installed for some reason. Like I said in part one, and I'm gonna say it again, I do have a video to show you guys how to install that properly so you can actually utilize Dart 10 within the OSD cloud. So don't worry about that. If you're into logs like me, you're able to look into the logs if something happens within the OSD cloud configuration. I'm going to show you guys where that is located. Now, on the MDT server, well, on my MDT server, on the desktop, we're going to get into the File Explorer. We're going to get into the C drive, and we're going to go into the program data folder. Now, this folder is hidden. Hopefully you guys know to unhide folders, but again, it is hidden. So I'm going to double click on that. And within here, you're going to see the OSD cloud folder. So once you go in there, you're going to see a bunch of other stuff. Those two ISOs are basically the default template that we created together. But the location that we need to go into is logs. And within logs, if you double click on templates, these are all the logs right here. If you're into reading logs and checking out what's going on behind the scenes, this is where you need to go. And that's it. That is how we create our new template. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.